My name's Neil Bubke, and I'm the Director of Music and Fine Arts here at the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay. Tonight, we're going to enjoy the second of our fall live stream concerts. It features Adrien and Braden Zitoun and their family, accompanied by Joseph Hauer. Hope you enjoy.
Welcome, everybody. My name is Adrien Zitoun. I'm actually a cellist with the Milwaukee Symphony Orchestra, and I'm here tonight with my wife, Braden, also a cellist, and my two children, also cellists. So four cellos, that's what you'll hear today. We have our wonderful pianist, Joseph Hauer, also with us here. Thank you, Joseph, for joining us. We are going to play tonight music by Faure, Popper, Ysaye, and I forgot the last one, Vivaldi, sorry. We also wanted to thank Neil very much for inviting us in your church, and we wanted to thank also the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay for that. The first piece on the program is going to be the second cello sonata by Gabriel Faure, a French composer. He was born in 1845 and died in 1924. He really pushed the harmonic progression in music and was at the forefront of new ideas of what they could do harmonically. And he was also very good melodist, writing beautiful melodies. And that's what you'll hear, especially in the second movement of the cello sonata. The second movement of the cello sonata actually comes from a piece that he originally wrote for a band, woodwinds and brass, to be played outside. It was a state commission piece in France that was to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the death of Napoleon I. The piece is so beautiful that Faure wanted to actually use it for something else, and he chose to use it in the middle section of the sonata. The sonata is in three movements. There's an allegro, an andante, and an allegro vivo, which means fast, slow, and fast, pretty much. So Joseph Hauer is playing with me, and I hope you enjoy the sonata.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, as you probably heard it, Faure really pushed the harmonies further, at least at this time. That's a little bit what Popper did on a different, in a different way. The next piece that we're playing is a Requiem by Popper. And Popper was actually one of the most famous and maybe the, you know, one of the best cellists of his time. He was actually pretty much born and lived at the same time as Faure in a different part of the Europe. He was born in 1843 and died in 1913. He was the principal cellist of both the opera house and the Vienna Philharmonic, which is a prestigious position, and he actually just was very lucky to be able to play chamber music with Johannes Brahms. He actually premiered some of the piano trios with him, among other things. And none other than the great pianist Franz Liszt asked him to become the teacher at the Budapest Conservatory in Hungary. Popper is not a very well-known composer, except for cellists, because he wrote a ton of etudes and show pieces and very difficult things, actually. So Faure pushed the harmonies, and Popper pushed the technique of the cello to its limits, pretty much. I'm inviting to the stage my wife, Braden, who is also a cellist and a freelancer, and my daughter, Amelia, who is 14 years old, and goes to Shorewood High School, and she takes cello lesson down in Chicago. It's called the Academy, which is part of the Music Institute of Chicago. And I invite them now to the stage to play the one movement, Popper Requiem.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Amelia, and tonight I will be playing Ysaye's solo cello sonata. Eugene Ysaye was a Belgian virtuosic violinist known for his impeccable technique. He is most famous for writing his six very difficult solo violin sonatas, each of which he dedicated to a different contemporary violinist of his time. However, less common is the cello sonata. Ysaye apparently studied cello in his youth, which helped him grasp understanding of the cello's sound and technique. This sonata portrays many beautiful, rich, deep, and often ghost-like tones, and showcases many different aspects of playing the cello. This sonata consists of four movements, each which displays a different character. I love playing this piece, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
Thank you.
very much. And we have one more piece for you on the program tonight. We're changing time period completely. We're going to the to the end of the 17th and beginning of the 18th century. A piece by Vivaldi, 1678-1741, that was his date. Vivaldi was a composer. He composed like so many works, it's actually hard to believe. He was also a virtuoso violinist. One of the most famous pieces are, you know, the Four Seasons that everybody heard. He was a priest, and actually he worked at in Venice at the Hospital della Pietà. And that was kind of a lot of things at the same time. It was an orphanage, it was a music school, it was a convent, it was all of that. So he composed a lot of music for the all-girl orchestra there, actually. And that's probably one of the pieces that he composed, the double cello concerto. So usually it's for two cellos, but we're very excited to be able to play that for you as a family. So my wife and Henry would be on part number two, and Amelia and myself will be on part number one. The parts are pretty equal, actually. You would see a lot of the same music going back and forth, almost creating a stereo effect, which was actually maybe something that they liked to do at the time. So we're going to play for you the first movement of the double cello concerto. It's fast and energetic and pretty exciting. And again, one more time, we'd like to thank Neil and the church, and also Joseph for playing with us. And we hope that you are excited like we are to hear us play, the four of us together. And yeah, and maybe we'll be joined by somebody else. Hello. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Zitoun family and Joseph. We really enjoyed your concert tonight. And thank you to all of you at home who tuned in to watch. We look forward to seeing you back next Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. Our original program featured the former head of the Milwaukee chapter of the AGO, Sherry Miaskowski. However, because of some damage that we sustained to our organ during a recent rainstorm, we're gonna put Sherry's concert later in November. And next Tuesday, we'll enjoy the music of Bluegrass. So we'll see you then, 7 o'clock next week. Thanks again.